Australian English. Australian English, AWA, NAU, is the set of varieties of the English language native to Australia. Although English has no official status in the Constitution, Australian English is the country's national and de facto official language as it is the first language of the majority of the population. Australian English began to diverge from British English after the first settlers, who set up the colony of New South Wales, arrived in 1788. By 1820, their speech was recognised as being different from British English. Australian English arose from the intermingling of early settlers, who were from a great variety of mutually intelligible dialectal regions of the British Isles, and quickly developed into a distinct variety of English which differs considerably from other varieties of English in vocabulary, accent, pronunciation, register, grammar and spelling. The earliest form of Australian English was spoken by the children of the colonists in early New South Wales. This first generation of native-born children created a new dialect that was to become the language of the nation. The Australian-born children in the new colony were exposed to a wide range of dialects from all over the British Isles, in particular from Ireland and Southeast England. The native-born children in the colony created the new dialect from the speech they had heard around them, and with it expressed peer solidarity. Even when new settlers arrived, this new dialect was strong enough to blunt other patterns of speech. A quarter of the convicts were Irish. Many had been arrested in Ireland, and some in Great Britain. Many, if not most, of the Irish spoke Irish and either no English at all, or spoke it poorly and rarely. There were other significant populations of convicts from non-English-speaking parts of Britain, such as the Scottish Highlands, Wales and parts of Cornwall. Records from the early 19th century show this distinct dialect in the colonies after the first settlement in 1788. Peter Miller Cunningham's 1827 book 2 Years in New South Wales described the distinctive accent and vocabulary of the native-born colonists that differed from that of their parents and with a strong London influence. Anthony Burgess writes that Australian English may be thought of as a kind of fossilised Cockney of the Dickensian era. The first of the Australian gold rushes, in the 1850s, began a large wave of immigration, during which about 2% of the population of the United Kingdom emigrated to the colonies of New South Wales and Victoria. According to linguist Bruce Moore, the major input of the various sounds that went into constructing the Australian accent was from Southeast England. Some elements of Aboriginal languages have been adopted by Australian English, mainly as names for places, flora and fauna, for example dingo, and locale culture. Many such are localised, and do not form part of general Australian use, while others, such as kangaroo, boomerang, budgerigar, wallaby and so on have become international. Other examples are cooey and hard yakka. The former is used as a high-pitched call, for attracting attention, pronounced, which travels long distances. Cooey is also a notional distance, if he's within cooey, we'll spot him. Hard yakka means hard work and is derived from yakka, from the Jagera/Yagra language once spoken in the Brisbane region. Also of Aboriginal origin is the word bung, from the Sydney Pidgin English, and ultimately from the Sydney Aboriginal language, meaning dead, with some extension to broken or useless. Many towns or suburbs of Australia have also been influenced or named after Aboriginal words. The best known example is the capital, Canberra, named after a local language word meaning meeting place. Among the changes starting in the 19th century were the introduction of words, spellings, terms and usages from North American English. The words imported included some later considered to be typically Australian, such as bushwhacker and squatter. This American influence continued with the popularity of American films and the influx of American military personnel in World War II, seen in the enduring persistence of such terms as okay, you guys and gee. The primary way in which Australian English is distinctive from other varieties of English is through its unique pronunciation. It shares most similarity with other Southern Hemisphere accents, in particular New Zealand English. Like most dialects of English, it is distinguished primarily by its vowel phonology. The vowels of Australian English can be divided according to length. The long vowels, which include monophthongs and diphthongs, mostly correspond to the tense vowels used in analyses of received pronunciation, RP, as well as its centering diphthongs. The short vowels, consisting only of monophthongs, correspond to the RP lax vowels. There exist pairs of long and short vowels with overlapping vowel quality giving Australian English phonemic length distinction, which is unusual amongst the various dialects of English, though not unknown elsewhere, such as in regional southeastern dialects of the UK and eastern seaboard dialects in the US. As with New Zealand English, the weak vowel merger is complete in Australian English, unstressed is merged into schwa, unless it is followed by a velar consonant. There is little variation in the sets of consonants used in different English dialects, but there are variations in how these consonants are used. Australian English is no exception. Australian English is non-rhotic, that is, the sound does not appear at the end of a syllable or immediately before a consonant. However, a linking can occur when a word that has a final R in the spelling comes before another word that starts with a vowel. An intrusive may similarly be inserted before a vowel in words that do not have R in the spelling in certain environments, namely after the long vowel and after word final. This can be heard in law, R, and order, where an intrusive R is voiced after the W and before the A. There is some degree of allophonic variation in the alveolar stops. As with North American English, intervocalic alveolar flapping is a feature of Australian English provocalic and surface as the alveolar tap after sonorants other than as well as at the end of a word or morpheme before any vowel in the same breath group. For many speakers, and in the combinations and are also palatalized, thus end, as Australian is only very slightly retroflex, the tip remaining below the level of the bottom teeth in the same position as for, it is also somewhat rounded. To say R the way Australians do, you need to say W at the same time, where older English and have fallen together as. The wine-wine merger is complete in Australian English. Yod dropping occurs after, and. Other cases of and, along with and, have coalesced too, and respectively for many speakers. Is generally retained in other consonant clusters. In common with most varieties of Scottish English and American English, the phoneme is pronounced as a dark, velarized, L. In all positions, unlike other dialects such as received pronunciation in Hiberno, Irish, English, where a light L, i.e., a non-velarized L, is used in many positions. Differences in stress, weak forms and standard pronunciation of isolated words occur between Australian English and other forms of English, which while noticeable do not impair intelligibility. The affixes ari, eri, ori, berry and moni, seen in words such as necessary, mulberry and matrimony, can be pronounced either with the full vowel or a schwa. Although some words like necessary are almost universally pronounced with a full vowel, older generations of Australians are relatively likely to pronounce these affixes with a schwa while younger generations are relatively likely to use a full vowel. Words ending in unstressed ila derived from Latin adjectives ending in illes are pronounced with a full vowel, so that fertile rhymes with fertile rather than turtle. In addition, miscellaneous pronunciation differences exist when compared with other varieties of English in relation to seemingly random words. For example, as with American English, the vowel in yogurt is pronounced as long O, rather than short O. Vitamin, migraine and privacy are pronounced with, as in mine, rather than, and respectively, pedophile is pronounced with, as in red, rather than, and urinal is pronounced with schwa rather than long I. As with British English, advertisement is pronounced with, tomato and vase are pronounced with, as in father instead of, zebra is pronounced with, as in red, rather than, and buoy is pronounced as in boy, rather than. Two examples of miscellaneous pronunciations which contrast with both standard American and British usages are data, which may be pronounced with da, instead of, day, and maroon, pronounced with, own, as opposed to, oon. Academic research has shown that the most notable variation within Australian English is largely sociocultural. This is mostly evident in phonology, which is divided into three sociocultural varieties: broad, general, and cultivated. A limited range of word choices is strongly regional in nature. Consequently, the geographical background of individuals can be inferred if they use words that are peculiar to particular Australian states or territories and, in some cases, even smaller regions. In addition, some Australians speak Creole languages derived from Australian English, such as Australian Creole, Torres Strait Creole, and Norfolk. The broad, general and cultivated accents form a continuum that reflects minute variations in the Australian accent. They can reflect the social class, education and urban or rural background of speakers, though such indicators are not always reliable. According to linguists, the general Australian variant emerged sometime before 1900. Recent generations have seen a comparatively smaller proportion of population speaking with the broad variant, along with the near extinction of the cultivated Australian accent. The growth and dominance of general Australian accents perhaps reflects its prominence on radio and television during the late 20th century. Australian Aboriginal English is made up of a range of forms which developed differently in different parts of Australia, and are said to vary along a continuum, from forms close to standard Australian English to more non-standard forms. There are distinctive features of accent, grammar, words and meanings, as well as language use. The ethno-cultural dialects are diverse accents in Australian English that are spoken by the minority groups, which are of non-English speaking background. A massive immigration from Asia has made a large increase in diversity and the will for people to show their cultural identity within the Australian context. These ethno-cultural varieties contain features of general Australian English as adopted by the children of immigrants blended with some non-English language features, such as the Afro-Asiatic and Asian languages. Although Australian English is relatively homogeneous, there are some regional variations. The dialects of English spoken in South Australia, Western Australia, New South Wales, Victoria, Tasmania, Queensland and the Torres Strait Islands differ slightly in vocabulary and phonology. Most regional differences are in word usage. Swimming clothes are known as cossies or swimmers in New South Wales, togs in Queensland, and bathers in Victoria, Tasmania, Western Australia, and South Australia. What most of Australia calls a stroller is usually called a pram in Western Australia, Victoria, South Australia, and Tasmania. Preference for some synonymous words also differ between states. Garbage, i.e., garbage bin, garbage truck, dominates over rubbish in New South Wales and Queensland, while rubbish is more popular in Victoria, Tasmania, Western Australia, and South Australia. The word footy generally refers to the most popular football code in an area, that is, rugby league or rugby union depending on the local area, in most of New South Wales and Queensland, and Australian rules football elsewhere. Beer glasses are also named differently in different states. Distinctive grammatical patterns exist such as the use of the interrogative A, also spelled A-R-I, which is particularly associated with Queensland. There are some notable regional variations in the pronunciations of certain words. The trap bath split is more complete in South Australia, which had a different settlement chronology and type from other parts of the country. This resulted in a British English influence that lasted longer than off other colonies. Words such as dance, advance, plant, graph, example and answer are pronounced with, as in father, far more frequently in South Australia while elsewhere in Australia the older, as in mad, is more common. L vocalization is also more common in South Australia than other states. In Western Australian and Queensland English, the vowels in near and square are typically realized as centering diphthongs, naya, whereas in the other states they may also be realized as monophthongs. A feature common in Victorian English is salary-salary merger, whereby a Victorian pronunciation of Ellen may sound like Alan to speakers from other states. There is also regional variation in before, as in school and pool. Australian English has many words and idioms which are unique to the dialect and have been written on extensively, with the Macquarie Dictionary, widely regarded as the national standard, incorporating numerous Australian terms. Internationally well-known examples of Australian terminology include outback, meaning a remote, sparsely populated area, the bush, meaning either a native forest or a country area in general, and g'day, a greeting. Dinkum, or fair dinkum means true or is that true? Among other things, depending on context and inflection. The derivative dinky-dee means true or devoted, a dinky-dee Aussie is a true Australian. Australian poetry, such as The Man from Snowy River, as well as folk songs such as Waltzing Matilda, contain many historical Australian words and phrases that are understood by Australians even though some are not in common usage today. Australian English, in common with several British English dialects, for example, Cockney, Scouse, Glaswegian and Geordie, uses the word mate. Many words used by Australians were at one time used in the United Kingdom but have since fallen out of usage or changed in meaning there. For example, creek in Australia, as in North America, means a stream or small river, whereas in the UK it means a small watercourse flowing into the sea. Paddock in Australia means field, whereas in the UK it means a small enclosure for livestock. Bush or scrub in Australia, as in North America, means a wooded area, whereas in England they are commonly used only in proper names, such as shepherd's bush and wormwood scrubs. Lightities, such as not bad, not much and you're not wrong, are also used, as are diminutives, which are commonly used and are often used to indicate a familiarity. Some common examples are arvo, afternoon, Barbie, barbecue, smoko, cigarette break, Aussie, Australian, and pressy, present/gift. This may also be done with people's names to create nicknames. Other English-speaking countries create similar diminutives. For example, Gazza from Gary, or Smitty from John Smith. The use of the suffix O originates in Irish Gaelic, Irish O, which is both a postclitic and a suffix with much the same meaning as in Australian English. In informal speech, incomplete comparisons are sometimes used, such as in that car is sweet as. Full, fully or heaps may precede a word to act as an intensifier, as in the waves at the beach were heaps good. This was more common in regional Australia and South Australia but has been in common usage in urban Australia for decades. The suffix "ly" is sometimes omitted in broader Australian English. For instance, really good can become real good. Australia's switch to the metric system in the 1970s changed most of the country's vocabulary of measurement from imperial to metric measures. Since the switch to metric, heights of individuals are listed in centimeters on official documents such as a driver's license, but older people understand and may speak of feet and inches. Where British and American vocabulary differs, Australians sometimes favor a usage different from both varieties, as with footpath, for US sidewalk, UK pavement, capsicum, for US bell pepper, UK green/red pepper, or doona, for US comforter, UK duvet, from a trademarked brand. In other instances, it either shares a term with American English, as with truck, UK, lorry, or eggplant, UK, aubergine, or with British English, as with mobile phone, US, cell phone, or bonnet, US, hood. A non-exhaustive selection of common British English terms not commonly used in Australian English include Australian usage in brackets, arctic/articulate lorry, semi-trailer, aubergine, eggplant, bank holiday, public holiday, bedsit, one-bedroom apartment, van lorry, garbage truck, cagoule, raincoat, candy floss, fairy floss, cash machine, automatic teller machine ATM, childminder, babysitter, chivy, nag, cling film, glad wrap/cling wrap, cooker, stove, courgette zucchini, skive, wag, dungarees, overalls, dustbin, garbage/rubbish bin, dustcart, garbage/rubbish truck, duvet, doona, elastoplast/plaster, band-aid, estate car, station wagon, fairy cake, cupcake/patty cake, free phone, toll-free, football, soccer, full-fat milk, full-cream milk, goosebumps, goose pimples, high street, main street, Hoover, V, to vacuum, horse box, horse float, ice lolly, ice block/icy pole, kitchen roll, paper towel, lorry, truck, marrow, squash, nettled, irritated, off-license, bottle shop, pavement, footpath, potato crisps, potato chips, reed/green pepper, capsicum, pilchard, sardine, pillar box, post box, plimsoll, sandshoe, pushchair, pram/stroller, saloon car, sedan, snug, V, kiss, swan, V, to go somewhere in an ostentatious way, sweets, lollies, tangerine, mandarin, utility room, laundry, Wellington boots, gumboots. A non-exhaustive list of American English terms not commonly found in Australian English include acclimate, acclimatize, aluminum, aluminium, bangs, fringe, bell pepper, capsicum, bellhop, hotel porter, broil, grill, burglarize, burgle, busboy, included under the broader term of waiter, candy, lollies, cell phone, mobile phone, cilantro, coriander, comforter, doona, counterclockwise, anti-clockwise, diaper, nappy, downtown, CBD, drywall, plasterboard, emergency break, handbrake, faucet, tap, flashlight, torch, frosting, icing, gasoline, petrol, golden raisin, sultana, hood, bonnet, jello, jelly, jelly, jam, math, maths, nightstand, bedside table, pacifier, dummy, period, full stop, parking lot, car park, popsicle, ice block/icy pole, railway ties, sleepers, rear view mirror, rear vision mirror, row house, terrace house, scallion, spring onion, silverware/flatware, wood cutlery, stick shift, manual transmission, streetcar, tram, takeout, takeaway, trash can, garbage slash rubbish bin, trunk, boot, turn signal, indicator slash blinker, vacation, holiday, upscale slash downscale, upmarket slash downmarket, windshield, windscreen. Terms shared by British and American English but not so commonly found in Australian English include abroad, overseas, cooler slash icebox, esky, flip-flops, thongs, pickup truck, ute, wildfire, bushfire. Australian English is particularly divergent from other varieties with respect to geographical terminology, due to the country's unique geography. This is particularly true when comparing with British English, due to that country's dramatically different geography. British geographical terms not in common use in Australia include coppice, cleared bushland, dell, valley, fen, swamp, heath, shrubland, meadow, grassy plain, moor, swampland, spinney, shrubland, stream, creek, woods, bush, and village. Even the smallest settlements in Australia are called towns or stations. In addition, a number of words in Australian English have different meanings from those ascribed in other varieties of English. Clothing-related examples are notable. Pants in Australian English follows American usage and refer to British English trousers, but in British English refer to Australian English underpants. Vest in Australian English pass also in American refers to British English waistcoat, but in British English refers to Australian English singlet. Thong in both American and British English refers to underwear, otherwise known as a G-string, while in Australian English it refers to British and American English flip-flop, footwear. There are numerous other examples, including biscuit, which refers in Australian and British English to hat in American English is cookie or cracker, but to a savory cake in American English. Asian, which in Australian and American English commonly refers to people of East Asian heritage, as opposed to British English, in which it commonly refers to people of South Asian descent. And potato chips, which refers both to British English crisps, which is not commonly used in Australian English, and to American English French fries, which is used alongside hot chips. In addition to the large number of uniquely Australian idioms in common use, there are instances of idioms taking differing forms in the various Anglophone nations. For example, home away from home, take with a grain of salt, and wouldn't touch with a 10-foot pole, which in British English take the respective forms home from home, take with a pinch of salt, and wouldn't touch with a barge pole, or a drop in the ocean and touch wood, which in American English take the forms a drop in the bucket and knock on wood. As with American English, but unlike British English, collective nouns are almost always singular in construction. For example, the government was unable to decide, as opposed to the government were unable to decide. Shan't, the use of should as in I should be happy if, the use of haven't any instead of haven't got any, and the use of don't let's in place of let's not, common in upper register British English, are almost never encountered in Australian or North American English. River generally follows the name of the river in question, as in North America, i.e., Darling River, rather than the British convention of coming before the name, for example, River Thames. In South Australia, however, the British convention applies, for example, the River Murray or the River Torrens. As with American English, on the weekend and studied medicine are used rather than British at the weekend and read medicine. Similarly, around is more commonly used in constructions such as running around, stomping around, or messing around, in contrast with the British convention of using about. In common with British English, the past tense and past participles of the verbs learn, spell, and smell are often irregular, learned, spelt, smelt. Similarly, in Australian usage, the to and I'll write to you is retained, as opposed to US usage where it may be dropped out, while prepositions before days may be omitted in American English, i.e., she resigned Thursday, they are retained in Australian English, as in British English, she resigned on Thursday. Ranges of dates used to, i.e., Monday to Friday, as with British English, rather than Monday through Friday in American English. When saying or writing out numbers, and is inserted before the tens and units, i.e., 162, as with British practice. However, Australians, like Americans, are more likely to pronounce numbers such as 1200 as 1200, rather than 1200. As in most English-speaking countries, there is no official governmental regulator or overseer of correct spelling and grammar. The Macquarie Dictionary is used by some universities and some other organizations as a standard for Australian English spelling. The Style Manual, for authors, editors and printers, the Cambridge Guide to Australian English Usage, and the Australian Guide to Legal Citation, ARI Prominent Style Guides. Australian spelling is closer to British than American spelling. As with British spelling, the U is retained in words such as color, honor, labor and favor. While the Macquarie Dictionary lists the R ending and follows it with the OR ending as an acceptable variant, the latter is rarely found in actual use today. Australian print media, including digital media, today strongly favor R endings. A notable exception to this rule is the Australian Labor Party, which adopted the American spelling in 1912 as a result of OR spelling's comparative popularity at that time. Consistent with British spellings, RE, rather than R, is the only listed variant in Australian dictionaries in words such as theatre, centre and manoeuvre. Unlike British English, which is split between eyes in words such as organise and realise, with eyes favoured by the Oxford English Dictionary and eyes listed as a variant, eyes is rare in Australian English and designated as a variant by the Macquarie Dictionary. A and oi are often maintained in words such as manoeuvre, paedophilia and fetus, excepting those listed below. However, the Macquarie Dictionary lists forms with e, for example, pedophilia, fetus, as acceptable variants and notes a tendency within Australian English towards uses in the e. Individual words where the preferred spelling is listed by the Macquarie Dictionary as being different from the British spellings include program, in all contexts, as opposed to program, inquire and derivatives inquired, inquiry, etc. as opposed to inquire and derivatives, analog, as opposed to digital, as opposed to analog, livable as opposed to livable, gorilla as opposed to gorilla, yogurt as opposed to yogurt, veranda as opposed to veranda, burka as opposed to burka, pasty, food, as opposed to pasty. Unspaced prepositions such as unto, anytime, all right and anymore are also listed as being as acceptable as their spaced counterparts. Different spellings have existed throughout Australia's history. A pamphlet entitled The So-Called American Spelling, published in Sydney sometime in the 19th century, argued that there is no valid etymological reason for the preservation of the U in such words as honour, labour, etc. The pamphlet also claimed that the tendency of people in Australasia is to excise the U, and one of the Sydney Morning Papers habitually does this, while the other generally follows the older form. What are today regarded as American spellings were popular in Australia throughout the late 19th and early 20th centuries, with the Victorian Department of Education endorsing them into the 1970s and the H newspaper until the 1990s. This influence can be seen in the spelling of the Australian Labour Party and also in some place names such as Victor Harbour. The concise Oxford English Dictionary has been attributed with re-establishing the dominance of the British spellings in the 1920s and 1930s. For a short time during the late 20th century, Harry Lindgren's 1969 spelling reform proposal, Spelling Reform 1 or SR1, gained some support in Australia in 1975. The Australian Teachers Federation adopted SR1 as a policy. SR1 calls for the short sound, as in vet, to be spelt with E, for example friend friend, head head. Both single and double quotation marks are in use, with double quotation marks being far more common in print media, with logical, as opposed to typesetters' punctuation. Spaced and unspaced am dashes remain in mainstream use, as with American and Canadian English. The DDMM/IE date format is followed and the 12-hour clock is generally used in everyday life, as opposed to service, police, and airline applications. There are two major English language keyboard layouts, the United States layout and the United Kingdom layout. Australia universally uses the United States keyboard layout, which lacks pound sterling, euro currency and negation symbols. Punctuation symbols are also placed differently from British keyboards. Thanks for watching. Don't forget like the video and don't forget to subscribe.